Everybody put your telephones in the air.
Boy, the way you blowing up my phone don't make me leave no faster. Put my coat on faster. Leave my girl no faster. I should've left my phone at home, cause this is a disaster. Calling like a collector. Sorry, I cannot answer. I feel like I live in Grand Central Station. Tonight I'm not taking no calls, cause I'll be dancing.
Everybody say we love you, Gaga.
We all took motorcycle lessons, I guess for safety reasons. So we went around a parking lot for about an hour, which one of the disciples actually trashed his motorcycle up against a curb, which was kind of hysterical. So we did that, and then they cut off part of the 101 freeway to the 134 freeway, and actually, like, cops would fly by us and section off the road, and we were doing like maybe 65 miles an hour on the freeway, like no helmet, which was sort of fun for a second. And then when I got back to the trailer, I was like, did I just freaking do that? Oh my god. But so we rode in a pack, but they had this one van that had a 360 crane on the top of it, which was amazing to watch. But we had little earpieces, and they'd go brake, brake. And so we'd be in a pack and we'd brake, and then the van would come up, and then this crane would cruise around and like get in your face. And it was intense, actually.
Really,
yeah.
Can Gaga ride a motorcycle at all? Or?
Actually, you know, I have to say about her. She wasn't riding she wasn't driving the bike, but she was riding on the back. And we first got on the freeway. We were flying down the freeway, and she got up on the back of the bike, and was like way up off the seat, like hanging backwards and stuff like that, which was quite the daredevil move. I have to admit. Yeah, it was pretty intense. But I'm right behind her, and I could see her hair flying, but she had all these jewels all over her, and every once in a while I could see, like, behind her bike, just a trail of jewels just dropping on the freeway, and it was kind of magic.
My first tour was with Lady Gaga. She was just brilliant on stage and off stage. She was an absolute sweetheart through the whole thing. You know, and I've been on tour with other people as well early on in my career. And you can have two kinds of experiences when you're opening up for somebody. You can have an experience where somebody is very appreciative of you opening up for their show, you know, because you're part of their show. Or you can have someone who just doesn't give what at all and not talk to you at all. But Lady Gaga, she was just, you know, one of those people who was really, really gracious. So, I mean, it was a really, really cool experience for me, you know, having it be my first tour, you know, obviously one of the biggest tours in the world. But this one is one of my faves from Lady Gaga. This one's called Bad Romance.
Right now, there are so many people in pop music that are doing so many great things for dance music. I mean, you're a fool. Anybody that's in this in all of South Beach right now, that discredits Lady Gaga for what she's done for electronic music is out of their mind. I mean, Red One and Space Cowboy and her in collaboration have done so much for making dance music mainstream. I'm sorry, but there wouldn't be a David Guetta top 10 hit. There wouldn't be this Black Eyed Peas record if it wasn't for the fame. I mean, the album got certified diamond. It sold 10 million records worldwide. The proof's in the sales. I mean, like, that the influence of that record is epic. And we're here and talking about all of this because of that.
I wanna be that child. What do we have to do to make it work here? What, we missed 50%. We're watching Gaga perform a song from her album Art Pop for the first time. I produced a couple from them, so it's pretty cool to see it.
Hey, yeah, keep way back there. We're not all the way in it. Dippy dippy.
Another story. 2 years ago, I lobbied to play Lady Gaga a demo idea that Anton did. After 3 days of logistically figuring out how I was going to do this, I jumped into her SUV on the way to a show she was playing at the Hollywood Bowl.
Yeah.
They give me an eighth-inch cable. I plug it into my iPhone. I play her 60 seconds of an idea. So she grabs my phone. She says, call Jimmy Iovine. We call Jimmy. She says, you got to sign this kid. I email Smith and Anton and say, I just sat with Gaga. She wants you to produce her whole record.
When you meet her, she is so real, and everything, any character that she does or any outfit that she puts on or any video she makes, it all comes from a real place inside. So she, for her, this is one side of her. And
I think when we met her the first time, we thought like, oh my God, she's so beautiful, and we should show people how beautiful she is.
Yeah, because she's gorgeous. She's a very happy, exuberant person that has so much to give, and I think you see that. And I think that's the big thing with her. It's all about giving, and it's about putting a message out there. And you know, there's many facets to that, but this is one of them.
So I went to a party the night before, and Gaga was at this party. And it was like we instantly hooked up, and we were laughing and joking and cracking up. And then she says, hey, I'm doing a session tomorrow. You want to pop by the studio? Guys, that's what we do. We're musicians. We pop by the studio. So I popped by the studio, and she was working on a song with Diane Warren. And I never met Diane Warren in my life before.
Really?
Of course, I knew who she was. Yeah, wow, never, ever. So we walked in, and I looked at the charts, and I was listening to what was going on, and Gaga kept singing a D note, D natural, over an F chord that they were playing. And so I just said, in a very loving way, I wasn't like, you know, trying to, I'm Mr. Nile Rodgers, but I just said, hey, you know, I said, Diane, check out Gaga. She keeps singing a D over the F chord. I said, that sounds like a country six chord. Well, why don't we like flip it and make it into a 13 chord, and it'll be really dope. And Diane Warren went, wow, that's the coolest thing I ever heard. So I rewrote the chart real quick, and then Gaga figured it out and played it. And then I said, hey, why don't we do this? And then Gaga, I wrote the chart, and she played it, and it was like, and Diane Warren was awesome. So we were there the whole night just hanging out, laughing, and it was just a blast.
You know what? I would say working with Lady Gaga was not necessarily surprising, but I did learn things that I necessarily didn't expect. And from
About makeup
and her musicianship.
Yes.
You know, she is, and I knew that she was a musician, but she came into that rehearsal, sat down at the piano, she was ready to go. And I love that. I appreciated that professionalism a lot, because I didn't know what to expect. She's such a big, big character.
Yeah.
And I thought, okay, how's she going to come in here? And
what did you perform with her?
I did a Grammy show with her. It wasn't the actual Grammys, but it was a pre-show,
yep.
The nominee party, I believe it was. And we did You and I. We did a version of You and I.
Nice.
Yeah, it was fun.
Nice.